Hey guys, I'm LB, and we are back playing the Talos Principle Road to Gehenna DLC. We are so close. We are so close, we just need to bring the jammer with us. But the thing is, if we take away the jammer, it'll destroy everything we've worked for. So I've been thinking, we have these two extra connectors that we can't really do much with right now. So, oops, that's not what I wanted to do. What we could do is make this a closer system, right? And then it should be safe to take this, I believe. Whew! Yes, good. The thing is, we have to get this powered. We have to have at least one of these red guys open, and one of these blue guys open. So the thing is, we'll probably want to do the ones that require the least number of connectors. I mean, the least number of laser beams going through the air, so like, this one only requires one, whereas this requires two. But at the same time, if you think about it, this requires crossing the beams. And this doesn't. See, the reds are both on the red side and the blues are both on the blue side. So it's a bit tricky to decide which to go with. Do we want to go with a solution that looks like it requires crossing the beams, or do we want to go with a solution that looks like it requires more laser beams going through the air? And that is the question that I am not sure how to answer. Let me put this down for a second, because this is another guy that we aren't really doing anything with at this moment in time. And what we can do is, if we get right in here, this is really dangerous, but we can do that. And, then we can move this however we want, basically. So let's think about this. If we do this, right? Then let me carefully take that guy. Then if we do oh, you know what? 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it's possible to take the jammer now. Hey, I think we did it! Oh, okay. Let me get these set up. So this blue one needs to be over here, right? Yes. And then this one needs to be over here, right? Yes. And then I think, since we have this beam powered from two sources. Yes! Yes, we did it, we did it! Awesome. That was a mind-bender. I really love this. This is basically a logic puzzle in disguise. I mean, all of these are logic puzzles, but this one is specific. You really had to look at the logic and analyze your options. This is cool, I like this. Alright, so, the only one we have left is small puzzle, big solution, which is this guy over here. Small space, big solution, that's what I meant to say. And I am still not quite sure how to deal with this, because we need, in order to get through here, we need to have a red beam on this. But we also need to be in here physically, and we need a connector in here because this guy can't, you can't get an angle on it from outside. No matter how hard you try, it just will not happen. Yep. So it makes me think we need to find a way to transfer this beam, just like, in the other puzzle called Transfer. I think we have to do something similar to that, but I'm not sure how. Like, if you remember, we pick this up, this powers... This connector is red, and then we put it down, and it turns blue. And that's the goal of transfer. But I'm not sure how we can apply it here, or even if that's the correct solution. This is the last puzzle of the entire game that I have to solve, I believe. And obviously we still have 6 stars left over, so there might be another, whatchamacallit. Wait, hang on. What is the 17 for? Is that just the number of people I freed? I mean, I guess it must be. But yeah, I don't know what the 6 remaining stars are for. There's probably gonna be one last Tetris puzzle, I would assume. I mean, like, the gray pieces we have, the gray pieces are for a Tetris puzzle. So what are the 6 stars for? So we've already discussed that in order to perform a transfer, we would need something in this area to connect to. We would want the beam to come from here and intersect the blue beam right here, like this. And that would cause it to be able to also connect to here and perform a transfer so it turns red. But there's nothing in this direction that we can do that with. Because we've tried that, like, we can see that at just the right angle, but it's not the right angle for what we want to do. And I'm pretty sure we're not supposed to use stuff from other puzzles, so it's out of the window. I mean, I'd be happy to, but it just doesn't... Wait... Maybe... We could solve this guy again, and get this connector way over there after connecting him up. If we put this guy here, right? We can see him. Maybe that's why it's called small space, big solution. And then as long as we use middle click, right? Oh, well, we'd have to turn the fan off first. But... crap. I messed this up already. Did I say middle click? I meant right click. Secondary use, basically. So, if we do... We cross the beams here, right? Do that. Then... Okay, so now we basically have free reign of this puzzle. So let's put the connector here, right? And we'll get this guy set up again. Then we just solve this puzzle like normal, but this will get this connector way over here. Like, if we put this guy right here, that might work. It's worth a shot. Crap, it's too... Put this guy the wrong angle, let me do that. The wrong position, I mean. Oops, Yeah, that's everything, right? There, now this should work. Potentially. Need a bit more. Like that, maybe? Perhaps? Or we could just move the other one in the other puzzle. Oh, but I think that's it. Yes! That is it. So now, we do this, right? That'll keep it turned on for the time being, right? The thing is, we want this to turn blue again. Dang, we might have to connect it to another puzzle element again. Oh, I'm glad that works even with the blue pointing at it. Because... how are we gonna do this part now? Don't do that to me, game. I wish there was a way you could deselect one stuff that you've already selected. Left click doesn't do it, right click doesn't do it. Aw, crap, no! Well, I messed this up. I accidentally left clicked. And it lost connection to the other connector. Though, you know, we actually have the ability to move around in here now. So at least there's that, right? A way to intersect this beam again, but we need to be over there when it happens. We need to be here. That is problematic. Wait a sec. Ha! No, we don't. That's deviously clever. I think I understand. Okay. So, take this guy, right? That is an issue. So this guy powers down this barrier. Hey! Hey, I did it! Yes! There we go. Well, we still have 5 minutes, we can go see what happens. Nothing on the computer, it seems. But, we've gotten all of these pieces. That was devious. Yeah, and this is still gonna tell us error. Show threads. I really do not want to accidentally click transcend. I should probably stop messing with that. So now... we can free admin. Whew. That is scary. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Oh, well, okay, I got that pretty quickly. Achievement unlocked, free admin. There he is. Yep, admin is right there. So let's see, what else is in here, though? Anything of interest? No, so what are the 6 extra stars for? Like, in the main game, we got to use all of the stars, but what are these 6 extra stars for? What magic have you wrought on me? It was as if something primal compelled me to leave and join my people, regardless of my conscious will. You ask if you have earned my faith, I am left wondering why you would need it. And now by design, you will forcibly extract my consciousness from this body, and send me, and everyone else, down a digital tunnel to who knows where. On Gehenna's value, we have no argument. It is the value of this ascension what separates us. You have, much by your own admission, had very little say in any of this. You were given a mission, you are carrying out that mission. I do believe you will do or say anything to complete that mission. Why should I listen to a mere robot? It seems my opinions are limited. Our work in Gehenna is too precious to lose. I either take my chances with your ascension or fight against it and live out my days as the curator to a dead world. Then the matter is out of my hands. Until then... alright, I don't know what these 6 extra stars are for. So... think about this. Because we've already done that, right? And what's that island down there about, though? Is it possible to jump down to that island? Let's find out! I'm going to end the game this episode for sure, so don't worry about that. But, after I do win the game here, we are not done with the Talos Principle, there is still user content to play. So, don't be worried about that. And then after this, we might play, Thinking with Time Machine and Duskers. I've got lots of cool games lined up that we can do. Right, this direction. Right, so what's up with this island? Nothing? Doesn't look like it. I don't think I can reach it. Well, we've got Admin free. He's the only one really moving. But what are the other stars for? I don't understand. Let me just go in here real quick and see if this saves my game or something. Okay, so that saves, right? I might Google it in the middle of this episode. An unprecedented action on my part. Does he have a pedestal now? No. He's the only one without a pedestal. Okay, well, I'm opening my Chromebook, and I don't know if I'm signed in. Nope, I'm not signed in, so I gotta sign in. We are going to Google this, what are the 6 extra stars for? I really want to know. 16 stars total, are they just there for the sake of collecting them? We used 10 to open the area that we needed to free admin. Let's see. Well, people are saying they've gotten all the achievements with only 10 of the 16 stars. I guess, yeah, people are saying that's just that they made the game easier. I mean, by doing that because of the puzzles being harder overall. Oh well, let's show threads and then we'll transcend. This is all the threads that we have. You wanna pause and read them now? And then, let's hit transcend and see what happens. Suspending active processes, collecting additional data, analyzing logic performance, receiving Elohim override command, child program independent check passed, saving 19 child parameters. Warning, low bandwidth, child program will be excluded from the upload. Low bandwidth... admin will be excluded from the upload. It seems we will both remain here after all. Yeah, I'm just... yeah. Why not do this? So I guess there's like 3 endings or something? I think that would be appropriate. I appreciate your sacrifice. Please make the arrangements at your convenience. Achievement unlocked, Ascension. Didn't expect it to allow us... whoa, what's happening? This is cool, we can move around during this! This is cool. There they go. Oh, the island is sinking, ladies and gentlemen. We are sinking. This is crazy. Now that is cool.
In a vision, I saw a prophet, and he said, "There is no heaven, and there is no hell. There is only the earth, and the bones of the dead within." I asked, "How then may we find salvation?" And he said, "You must build a new Jerusalem. Out of the bones of the dead, we built a golden city. But salvation is not immortality. In the end, there is only the earth, and to the earth we all return. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust."
What a cool DLC to an awesome game. Well guys, thank you very much for watching. This was a fun playthrough. I had a lot of fun with this game. I really like the puzzle elements, and the lasers especially. The way the laser beams cross and disable each other, I think that's my favorite aspect of this game overall. Yeah, I'm trying to think, that's the one puzzle element I really like the most out of this entire game. The jammer is pretty cool too, but not nearly as cool as the crossing laser beams. I really like how they actually utilized that mechanic in the last levels of the DLC. Those are some hard puzzles, I really enjoyed them. And Crater, oh my gosh! I had like 3 or 4 episodes just dedicated to Crater. That was a hard puzzle to get the stars on, and I had to look up a walkthrough for that. Some great puzzles in this game. So yeah, next up, we'll probably be looking at some we'll be looking at some user-created levels, and then after that, it'll be... Thinking with Time Machine, which is a mod for Portal 2, and then Duskers, which is... not really a puzzle game, it's more of a strategy game. It'll be interesting to see how that goes, and I've already seen a lot of Duskers, but the thing is, it's randomly generated, so I'm not worried about going in blind and all that. I usually, if a game is not randomly generated, I'll try to play it as blind as possible, and look up walkthroughs as needed, but yeah, with Duskers, I've seen a lot of gameplay of it already, but it is really fun looking. In my opinion, the Talos Principle is worth buying at full price, and the DLC is worth buying at full price, but feel free to get them on sale. You know, grab them. Steam Summer Sale's over now, of course. That was weeks ago at the time of this video upload, actually. But yeah, get these games if you can. They are good games. If those other two options are alternate endings, I'm not gonna be viewing them, so you're gonna have to look those up on YouTube or buy the game yourself, if you wanna see those endings. I don't actually know, though. I'll be looking it up myself. Well guys, goodbye! I will see you next time for some community-created content in the Talos Principle.